Thank you for spending your Mother's Day with us. Unless you're not watching this on Mother's Day, of course, then thank you for spending your hour with us, I guess. So we're going to be reviewing this movie called I Care A Lot. It's it came out 2021, and we watched it a couple of months ago. And we've just been reviewed over the plot because we probably forgot. Of course, by we, I mean me and my lovely mother, I figured this is the best thing I could think up with for something being considered around Mother's Day, because I couldn't think of anything else, so I thought I might as well just get my mother on here because she has a few opinions of her own. Goes without saying, if you haven't seen the movie, I'd definitely go watch it before listening to us talk about it, because I feel like a lot of people just like listening to overviews of the movie instead of watching it itself, and obviously we can't include every line of dialogue, and it's a good movie, and it's quite funny as well. So if that appeals to you, then I'd definitely go watch it. But if you're here if you've seen the movie, or you're just interested in learning what it's about, then welcome. So we might as well get started straight away. It's basically about a woman called Marla, who's a scammer. She gets older people in homes. She forces them in homes, and she's made a lot of enemies over the years. And she gets a hot tip that this woman called Jennifer, who's an older woman, is like very rich, and she has a lot of connections and things. So they move her into a home, sell her all her belongings, find a Dropbox which is full of diamonds, and proceed to try and live their lives having done this. But they didn't know that her son was a mafia boss, and the movie is just about them constantly clashing with each other. And it's quite an interesting story because it's two bad guys going at each other. You don't know quite who to root for, because one's a mafia boss who've killed people. Like, he kills the one of their friends who's a doctor, who told them that Jennifer was up for moving out. But you've also got this woman who scams older people and stops their relatives from seeing them and things like that. So what did you think of the plot, Mother?
I think it's very good.
Mm.
I think she's an evil woman.
Yes.
Because it's amazing how quickly she gets the old lady in a home, and with the same day, she sold everything.
Yeah, she sold the house,
she sold everything in it.
Yes.
She's paid off the doctor,
mm-hmm.
who has said that she needs to be in a home.
Yep.
And she's paid the person that owns the home.
Yep.
So that's it. She's got her in, and there's no getting her out.
No, there isn't.
But she doesn't think that the woman has any relatives.
No, she doesn't, because they said they all died, and that was what was so special about her.
That the whole house and everything was up for grabs, basically.
Yeah, and she wouldn't have any problems with, like, sons coming up to her and going, "You did this, you..."
Which is what happened with the first person that we see.
Yes, it's called his mother. I've got it written down. Hold on. Mr. Feldstrom.
So his mother's in.
Yeah, his mother's in.
And he wants her out.
But she won't... Marla won't let him see her, will he?
Because the judge is on Marla's side.
Yes.
All the time.
Because she's like...
She's projecting that she's an angel saving everybody, isn't
she's,
she?
She's like got dementia, she's got all these problems, and that's why she needs to be in the home.
And she's basically telling the judge that Mr. Feldstrom hasn't looked after, can't look after.
She was on the verge of death, basically. And so her and her girlfriend, Fran, hurry these older people out. And like I said, the movie's about just Roman, who's the mafia boss, who's also played by Peter Dinklage, which I think is the funniest thing.
He's very good.
He is very good. Chasing her down and doing these horrible things, like sending her off a cliff, beating up his girlfriend, girlfriend.
It's lucky that she went missing just before her birthday.
Mm.
Because he only sees her once a year, doesn't he, on her birthday? Because
yeah.
It's not safe to see her any other time.
It's kind of unlucky for Marla, isn't it? That
yeah.
The one day she gets her in, and especially with the birthday coming up, like you said, when She asked what day it was, and Marla just went, "It's this day," and she just sat, laughed, and she went, "You're so screwed."
Mm.
And it was just like that one day out of the year that she could have hurried her out of that house happened to be on her birthday.
So he sent a man, as he always does every year, apparently, to pick her up.
Mm. Which
and
was
she wasn't there, and the house was for sale, and there was somebody else in the house.
Yes, and he sends a lawyer to try and get her out, doesn't he?
Once he finds out where she's gone, yeah. Yes.
And he offers her about £150,000.
Which she says, if he can offer me that on the first offer, there's a lot more to be had.
Practically, so she refuses, he takes up with the judge, and the judge is on Marlowe's side, obviously, otherwise the movie would just end there. And she gets kidnapped by Roman, offers, she says, give me 10 mil. He says no, sends her off a cliff. She then gets out, gets another house, which she hurried someone out of. Drugs, or knocks out Roman, leaves him naked in the middle of the road. He's then found by a jogger, classified as unknown, and Marla then becomes his legal owner, which was like the big...
Which she does with all the her clients. It's the same judge, swayed by her again.
But the way she deals with everything, like the way she hurries people out and the way she gets them in that psychiatric hospital is very clever. Like, she goads Jennifer, who's the old lady, to attacking her, and then uses that as proof of she's mentally unstable.
It, yeah.
Yeah, and then gets her into a psychiatric hospital.
And then they drug them because they're violent in Rocket. And then they've got them.
Yeah, she, like, minimises her food, doesn't she, and pushes her exercise to the max and just tries to physically torture her until she tells her who she really is, because Jennifer is a false ID, because obviously with Roman being her son, she can't really go around telling her, hey, my son's a mafia boss.
Because he's allegedly dead anyway.
Yeah,
isn't
he's supposed to have died in the fire. So what did you think of the ending?
Well, it's quite comical how it flips from one of them being
in charge
to the other. And it flips all the time.
One of them taking the other for a ride, basically.
Mm.
And then it practically switches. I believe Roman has her in control more than she has him for the remains, sort of most of the movie. Because even that he's torturing her, basically, by, like, killing her friend, beating up her
girlfriend.
I know,
but even though he's doing that, and he almost managed to kill her, it was only the fact that she managed to swim away, otherwise she'd have been dead. But even so, he's been really awful and evil. He's still on his side because of all the things that she's done, and you see the wall of old people that she's got, that she's basically conned them out of everything and stuck them away to die, basically.
Basically.
So you're massively on his side, even whatever he's doing. Oh, yeah, he's drowning her and killing her and he's beating her up, but you think, yeah, go for it, son.
Especially, I imagine as a mother, you're like, yeah, if I couldn't see my son, I'd want him to kill whoever's keeping us apart.
I won't go so strongly as kill, but you can see where he's coming from, and all he's doing at the near the end is just trying to survive this.
Yeah.
Even though she's just, you know, he's a mafia boss and she's just a woman.
She's
doing a job.
Doing her legal job.
Yeah, she's miles ahead of him.
Yeah, it's amazing how cleverly she, like, avoids him and gets his mother into the psychiatric hospital. And
he sends people in to get her out.
Yeah.
Which doesn't go so well.
Nah, because Alexei gets, which is the ugly, ugly mafia guy who they send in, he gets captured and they find out that he has two siblings called Roman and someone else, and that's how they find out who her son really is. And then the ending was a very bit of a shock, and I feel like it split a lot of audiences between, she deserved it and she goes through all of that and just to get shot at the end. What is this movie?
Well, it is bizarre that they start a company together in the end,
which
is just because he sees that she's got potential.
Yeah, she's like, you've kept my mother from me, so you know I'm going to do that to other people.
I know, which is not good. But,
but he hugs his mother at the end, doesn't he? Which is nice. And then Mr. Feldstrom, the guy who she wouldn't let see him, he shoots her.
He does. While saying
that his mother died and alone because they wouldn't let him see her. Especially since in the beginning of the movie it shows him like running in and like tackling a guard to try and get to see her.
Yeah, that's to see his mother.
And yeah.
That's quite sad to think that how many people she's kept away from their mothers or their fathers.
Mm.
So that's quite, yeah, that I think that sort of stings a bit.
It was like,
so when he does shoot her, you can see where, you know, the pain that he's gone through times that board. I mean, it must have been 200.
Yeah.
So it's lucky that there wasn't a queue. Frankly.
It was a bit like you're just still stepping like the Orient Express. It's a bit like, you know, that show we watched on Gogglebox where that gay guy dies alone because his mother goes downstairs instead of letting her friend see him.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, it was a bit like that. But he didn't get shot. And yeah. So so the protagonists weren't great. They were scam artists trying to get the people out.
Yeah, it was bad and bad, and which side are you on?
Yeah, basically, it wasn't like, oh, they have redeeming qualities. Oh, she donates to charity. Oh, he, I don't know, just wants to see his mother. Because both the things they do to get what they need, very, very bad. Like, Roman goes on the very physical side, like killing her friend.
And almost killing her.
She goes on the more mental side and like...
And almost killing her girlfriend.
Yeah. And she goes for the more mental side by going after his mother, which she actually has control over, and like sort of torturing her, which makes Roman, you know, angrier at her and feel more pain. So how do you think it was cast? Do you like that?
Yes.
Yes.
I thought it was well cast, really.
I'm just going to pull up the actors real quick. But the fact that they keep casting these big, scary roles as Peter Dinklage is just the funniest thing to me.
He's a good actor, though. He pulls it off.
Oh, he definitely is a good actor. I don't think anyone would dispute that. But the fact that he is about... I don't want him to come after me. We'll say generously he's about 5'5", when he's really like 4 foot. The fact that he's able to stay menacing, and especially with his voice that's used for a lot of band-mastered people as well. The fact that it's sort of consistent with the way he threatens people, and he does come off very threatening in the movie, which I think is quite impressive.
Absolutely.
I think the other actors did very well. I don't think there was, like, a hint of, wait, are we the bad guys from Rosamund Pike?
Rosamund Pike, yeah, there you go. She was very good.
There wasn't any, like...
Because you do dislike her.
Yeah, there isn't any regret or in her face, which, you know, could come across quite easily.
That's the thing, yeah. Yeah, that's all you want to see, really. That she comes and realises what she's done wrong. Only no, what she does is step it up. At the end.
Yeah, basically.
Like, makes billions out of it.
Basically, she just thinks, well, he did this to me, so I'm going to do this back to him. She never stops and thinks, wait, I was the first one to do something bad to him. It is like two siblings just falling out. Like, instead of thinking, hang on, I threw away his toy and that's why he kicked me. You just think, well, he kicked me, so I kicked him back.
But I don't think her partner...
Fran.
She wanted to run away.
Yeah.
She never did.
No.
Didn't Marla. She was always... She placated Fran.
Hmm.
Okay, yes, we'll pack our stuff. But I don't think she ever really thought of running away because she didn't actually sort of...
Pack up?
No, not a business.
No.
So well, I don't think she was ever of the mind that she was ever going to let him win.
Well, she could have done it if... she hadn't been knocked out and put into her boot because she was like, I can't find her passports. And she was like, maybe try the drawer or something. But that's when everything goes bad. Like, Marla gets kidnapped, Fran gets beaten up and nearly exploded.
Yes. Mm.
Which she's not as bad as Marla is. She's definitely an accomplice to the crime.
Yes.
But I don't think she deserved what she got. Like, she got brutally beaten up.
Yes.
Probably got gas poisoning. And had a wife die at the end because they get married at the end, don't they?
Yes.
So I think that's a bit harsh for old Fran there.
Well, she doesn't know all that she's doing.
Yeah.
So she's definitely an accomplice.
Mm. So what do you think about, like, how the movie handled the general theme of pouring people in?
Well, I think it's scary.
It is very scary. Because
if that's how it is in America, that is that easy to do, or potentially here.
I'll stay in the UK, thanks.
Well, yeah, for old people, that has seriously got to be scary. That somebody can take control of your life through going through court and not actually even needing to speak to you.
Especially since if they're older people, they won't have... Well, 9 times out of 10, they won't have, like, the common sense or the, you know, wit to...
I don't think that either.
Fight against it as well as someone who...
You've not got the wherewithal, basically.
Knew what they were doing.
You might have the wit.
You're
fighting against the system.
Yeah.
And the system is a lot mightier than one person on their own.
I imagine if it's like an old lady living on her own, apart from like Jennifer, obviously, for a long period of time, she won't be very well equipped or know much about the legal system enough to
fight against it. Well, no, you fight against it, don't you?
But especially since when they get them into that home, they, like, cut their connections off.
They've had it, yeah, because they take the mobile phones.
Yeah, and then...
They can't ring anybody.
Because Jennifer's constantly, like, give me my phone, and they're like, sorry, we can't give her. And then they drug her because she's, like, insisting, give me my phone and let me get out of here, give me some fresh air.
And that's the scary thing. If they take away all your communications and knock you away, what on earth are you supposed to do?
I mean...
Once you're in...
It does get to the point where, like, the Matthew people try and break her out of the hospital. And she's like, well, it took you long enough. And at that point, when he's running through and shooting people, and he's literally got hold of her hand, you can kind of see where they're like, maybe she's a bit of a threat.
Yeah, because she wasn't concerned about any of it, was she? She was
no.
About time, right, let's kick some ass and get out of here.
If she could, I feel... Well, she strangles Marla, doesn't she? For a bit. For like a solid like 5 seconds while she's like, you'll die alone, no one loves you, all that jazz. I stole your diamonds as well. I hope you didn't like them. But it is just this constant battle between Marla, who's got control of Roman's mother, and is just constantly just trying to, well, survive as well as get their money. And
I just think it's very scary if that's the future for old people. Because we're all going to get old.
Yeah. Well, the system might change by then.
Let's hope so.
Yeah, because I don't want to be hurried into an old people's home. Especially like someone who can do it like that.
And take everything. Yeah. So even if you managed to get out, you'd have nothing to get out to.
Exactly.
No.
You live with your son.
Let's hope that's not true. Oh, I'm coming to live with you. That's good.
I didn't say that.
I heard you.
You can live with the other one. You can live with Toby.
Thanks.
Alright. Well, I think that's everything. Thanks for joining me for this, however long it was.
Hopefully you've seen the movie or we've just ruined everything for you.
Yeah, you should probably watch the movie. It's a bit late telling you this now, but hopefully you've just... told the movie. But I suppose we have to go into depth. We have to go in depth. To truly talk about the movie, because I feel like if you try to avoid spoilers, then you're not going to really get into what the meaning of the movie was, especially with the ending that it was of Mara surviving all that and then getting shot at the end.
She deserved it, in my opinion.
I'm of the mindset that if she can survive everything that's been thrown at her and then just someone comes up with a gun and she's screwed... I think it was... I'm only just realising now how clever it was that they made it feel like she was immortal, like she could do anything, and then at the end making it seem like she is human and she can be put down by a simple gun.
Mm.
I'm only just realising that now. I think we've wrapped up about everything that we need to. Again, thanks for joining me for Mother's Day.
Thank you.
Allowing me to get a Mother's Day video out because I couldn't think of anything. And I will see you tomorrow. Yes. All right, bye.
Good morning, Miss Peterson. I'm sorry to disturb you so early. The court has ruled that you require assistance in taking care of yourself.
I'm fine.
I'm afraid it's not up to you to decide. The court has appointed me to be your legal guardian.
What?
You have to come with me. And remember, I'm here to help.
My name is Marla Grayson.
I'm just someone who cares.
Marla Grayson, you've had amazing success. What's your secret?
There is no secret, Peter.
She forces them into the home, auctions off their house,
and uses the proceeds to pay herself.
Because caring is my job.
Bitch! I will grab your dick and balls, and I will rip them clean off.
Big deal maker.
I know what you do here. Your hustle.
Look at all these cash cows on your wall just leaking money into your account.
But Jennifer Peterson, she's off limits.
She has very powerful friends who can make life uncomfortable for you.
How uncomfortable are we talking?
Hello, Marla Grayson.
I don't like you.
You only just met me.
There's two types of people in this world. Predators and prey. I don't lose. I won't lose. I'm never letting you go.
Oh, you're in trouble now.
I am a fucking lioness.